Hello, Patriots. I'm Lee Watts, and this is Patriot Point, your source for Kentucky news and analysis from somebody who's not a crazy liberal, which is most of the other mainstream media. We're going to give you this week top 10 bills to watch that are up for a vote in next year's legislative session. It's crazy to think about, but next year's legislative session is like only like 45 days away or less. It's coming really quick. Here are 10 bills to watch. There's some good ones. There's some bad ones. Some of them you're going to be like, this is crazy. I can't even believe they're trying this. Others you're going to think are great. Now, with all of these, jot down the numbers of these bills and also jot down what you can do about it. Because just having an opinion about it doesn't really help to promote a bill or to stop a bill. The way to do that is to contact your legislator and let them know what your voice is, because that's the way they can accurately represent you. There's two ways that you can do this. First of all, you can give them a phone call. There are a phone number for the Kentucky Capitol to leave a message for your legislator is 1-800-372-7181. Now, let's say you're like, well, I don't want to leave a phone call. I just want to send them an email. Everybody has the same email address. All you have to do is put the first name of your legislator, first name, dot, and then put their last name at lrc.ky.gov. That stands for Legislative Research Commission, Kentucky Government. So that's the way that you can call them. That's the way that you can send them an email. Let your voice be heard. And now let's look at 10 bills to be watching during the new legislative session. And if we've got time, and we're going to have time because I'm the one who decides how much time we've got. If we have time, I'm going to add in 3 bills which have not been written, but should be. So let's look at some of these bills right here. First of all, I think this is the one which I believe right now is the most important bill before the Kentucky State Legislature this year. It is BR. And all of these bills are going to be called BR. That stands for Bill Request. And during this time of year, they can pre-file a bill, and that's what it's called. At the beginning of the year, when the session starts, all of these will then be called either House Bill or Senate Bill, and given a number. The number might change once that happens, but as of right now, the number one bill I think this is one to stand on is BR-106. This bill, written by Kentucky State Representative Savannah Maddox, has a bunch of co-sponsors. We need a bunch more. The main thrust behind this bill is it says, listen, your employer, the government, schools, everybody everywhere is not allowed to demand that you get a vaccine before you go to their school, before you get a job, to keep your job. The government can't do it. This is a tremendously powerful bill to protect the rights of the people. There are those who are opposing it saying, oh, this is putting a mandate on businesses. That is incorrect. A mandate tells someone what they must do. This is the reverse of that. This is saying you are not allowed to do this. This is a bill to protect the freedom of the people. And some people say, well, what about businesses? And if these two things come in conflict? Well, let me clear that up real clear for you real quick. If there's ever a conflict between the people and government, you know who comes first? We the people come first. If there's ever a conflict between the people and corporations, you know who comes first? The people come first. The people's rights come first. This is not a government called we the corporations. This is a government called we the people. And this is a bill to protect the rights of the people. It's just like years ago when we had a bunch of these racist Democrats who passed all these Jim Crow laws and everything. We had to go in and get laws passed that would prevent corporations from denying the rights of black people or other minorities from getting goods and services. It was to protect the rights of the people, is why the laws had to be put in place to stop corporations who were doing that. Same thing today. BR-106 would protect the people and prevent corporations from saying, you're not allowed to work here unless you give up your rights. You're not allowed to shop here unless you give up your rights and you get stuff injected into you against your will. And any right that we give up is also a right that we are giving away for our children, because our children are going to be like, my right to work and to keep my body the way I want, mom and dad gave that away to the corporation. Well, mom and dad don't have to. This is a wonderful, positive bill to protect the rights of the people. So, wonderful bill, BR 106, and I hope you'll support that one. Now, let's talk about the second one, which is BR 133. I love this bill. This is the term limits bill. And I think that's what is desperately needed. Our government was never designed to be run by professional politicians, people who just get in office and stay there their whole career. Andy Beshear. Oh, I'm sorry. I had a little cough there. People who just get in office and they stay in office for way too long. Remember, this is supposed to be a government of the people, by the people, for the people. Let's not forget that first one there. Of the people, not of the politicians that have been up there for 20, 30, 40 plus, 50 plus years when you're looking at some of the people in Congress. So BR 133 would set term limits specifically for the Kentucky State Legislature. It would set a limit of 16 years for those serving in the Senate and 12 years for those serving in the House of Representatives. This would require an adjustment to Section 32 of the Kentucky Constitution. So I think this is a great bill. It would allow enough time to have some of that institutional memory. People have been there 16 years, 12 years. That's plenty of time to have the history of before passed on to the next group. But longer than that, why do we have term limits for governors? Why do we have term limits for the president? We do this because we're like, listen, that is too much power for one person for too long. It should be limited, and a government that should be made up of we the people, not a government run by people who've just been doing that for years. And so I hope that you will support BR 133. Let's talk about one which I think is, well, let me put it nicely, that's dumb. All right, this is just a dumb bill. And this is BR 91. And this would increase the minimum wage in Kentucky to a required $15 per hour. Now, let's think about that. That's almost double what we have now. So you can drop out of school, have no training, no experience, no anything, no skills whatsoever, and you can get $15 an hour. Well, if that happens, what's going to happen to those who actually have training, who have experience, who have certifications? They're not going to want $15 an hour. They're going to want, you know, two or three times that. It's a recipe for massive inflation. And as we've seen, the federal government has been moving in socialist policies, incentivizing people not to work. It is artificially adjusting the cost of labor already, and we're already seeing inflation, and this would be the worst. This would be like throwing gas on a fire. Terrible bill, BR 91, to increase the minimum wage. This should be decided by the free market system, should decide what a free, a reasonable wage is. Let's talk about the number four bill, which is really two different bills. I'm going to kind of cheat here and combine two bills into one. These are BR 60 and BR 69. Two different bills, but they accomplish the same thing with different wording. And it would say we are not going to have any of this racist, critical race theory in Kentucky schools. Who can say amen right there? This is just teaching racism. So this would say, listen, we are not going to allow this to be in Kentucky public schools. So that is a great thing. Critical race theory, CRT, which the liberals have got wise to the conservatives finding out about this and how they're pushing racism. And they just kind of relabeled it. They call it DEI, standing for diversity, equity, and inclusion. And then sometimes they call it SEL, which is social emotional learning. So CRT, DEI, and SEL, no good. Throw them out. It's about as bright as M-O-U-S-E. Mickey Mouse. This is no good. I hope that you will support BR 60 and 69 to keep this out of Kentucky schools. Now, the exact opposite of this is the next bill, number five. We're halfway through. This is BR 427, which is written by one of the most outspoken leftists in the Kentucky State Legislature, which would require critical race theory and all the radical leftist agenda to be taught in the public schools. So this is BR 427, absolutely probably the worst one that's been written in the entire state legislature this year so far. And keep in mind, by the way, even as I'm speaking to you, more bills may have been written, which will be incredibly important. There's more than I'm talking about today, but for the sake of time, I'm just giving you 10 that we should keep our eyes on. We'll probably be doing another list like this as we get closer to the session, and then definitely during the legislative session, talking about different bills that people should either support or oppose. Well, we're on the back half of them now. Number 6 is BR 154. This is a tremendously great bill. This is called the Save Women's Sports Act. And this is a bill I've seen passed in different versions in about 10 different states now. I think Texas is the most recent one to do that this summer. And it basically says, if you're a boy, you cannot compete in girls' sports. Crazy you have to have a bill for that, but unfortunately, that's the world that we live in today. So this would say, if you are a boy, you cannot enter the girls' sporting divisions. So I think that's great. The Save Women's Sports Act. Why all the feminist groups aren't pushing for this is beyond me. Okay, let's go to their next one, number 7, BR 171. Everybody out there who is a big a Second Amendment person, a good gun rights, oh, you're going to like this bill. It says, there will be no federal gun bans or regulations in Kentucky. The feds can pass or just make up through mandates anything they want. But this would say, listen, Kentucky, right now, we're putting something in place where we are nullifying that. This really comes back to the right of nullification that was originally in the Constitution. It's still there in the 10th Amendment. The 10th Amendment of the Constitution of the United States says, hey, any right we do not specifically list that the federal government has, they do not have it, and all the rights not listed are reserved to the states. So this is one where the state of Kentucky is saying any of these federal gun bans, gun grabs, gun regulations don't apply here in Kentucky. So a wonderful pro-Second Amendment bill. That is BR 171. On a related topic is BR 208. This is our 8 out of 10 bill. BR 208 says there wouldn't be a Kentucky sales tax on guns and ammunition. I'd be for that. We're already taxed enough already. Think about this. When you get your check, you've already been taxed on that, haven't you? They take taxes out before they give it to you. And then the money that is left, they tax that again with income tax, don't they? So it was taxed before I got it, and then it was taxed after I had it, and then I get taxed when I spend it. So taxed way too much already anyway. Let's talk about bill number 9. This is BR 440, bill request 440. And this would require there be a school resource officer in every Kentucky public school. Now, let me explain the reason why that is. A few years ago, the Kentucky State Legislature passed a law that says, listen, we want a trained, armed person in every Kentucky school. So if there's a shooting, we have an armed and trained person there to defend the children, to defend our teachers. And they designated the person to be the school resource officer. Well, a bunch of these hardcore leftist districts, they're like, oh, no, no guns. They just say, well, okay, we'll have that person armed, but we just don't have a school resource officer. Well, we just don't have that. Well, this would require and say, yes, you will. Somebody will take on this role. Again, the leftists just trying to get around the law that would protect Kentucky students and protect Kentucky teachers. A wonderful bill to provide that protection, BR 440. And our last of our top 10 bills to really keep an eye on this year is bill request number 359. And this has to do with child care centers. And it would say, child care centers cannot be refused to be given a license or have their license revoked if they are not going to mask or vaccinate children. It's like, and that's what's been threatened through Andy Beshear. The health department's being used like the Gestapo against healthcare centers, saying, listen, you got 2-year-olds in there, you better have a mask. At one point, double mask. And some of them said, no, this is ridiculous to do to children. It's borders on child abuse. We're not going to do it. threatened with having their licenses revoked, not granted, or not renewed. So this would be a wonderful bill, BR 359, to help protect our child care industry and their rights in Kentucky. If you want to send your kid to some facility that does it, feel free. But those who don't want to do it should have their freedom protected. That's what it all comes down to. What is government's job? Government's job is to protect the rights of the people. That's the reason for BR 359. That's the reason for BR 106. Government's job is to protect the rights of the people, not to protect the rights of the government, not to protect the rights of corporations. I am pro-industry. I am pro-free enterprise. But the people always come first. Protect the rights of the people, or vote them out and put in somebody who will protect the rights of the people. So these are 10 bills to watch. Now I want to talk very briefly about three bills which have not been written. This is just something that Lee Watts has come up with, and I hope somebody out there will encourage a legislator to write these bills. Very quickly, number one, daylight savings time. Just do this, pick a time. I don't care if it's daylight savings. I don't care if it's the rest of the year. Just pick one time, and let's just make that is the time for the rest of the year. Instead of this bouncing back and forth, it brings confusion. The reason for doing this is long since passed with the world today, technology. We live in a society that doesn't shut down when the sun goes down. It continues going and has for many decades. And it brings confusion. There's already some states that have got out of this mess. Hawaii doesn't do it anymore. Arizona doesn't do it anymore. Puerto Rico doesn't do it. There's a lot of places that are like, listen, this is ridiculous. It's confusing, kind of hurts industry, and let's get rid of it. Pick the early time, the late time. I don't care. Just pick one and go for it. Oh, and they had a bill a few years ago to do this, and they said, well, we'll do this, but only if the federal government decides to do it. No, don't leave this up to the feds. Make a call and let's get this done. I think it'd be great. It's not a huge issue, but it sure make life a little more convenient. The number two thing I think it'd be great, I've talked about this before, is spreading out the legislative session. Right now, on even numbered years, the legislature meets for 60 days, and on odd numbered years, they work for 30 days. They squish all of these working days at the beginning of the year, and there's so many bills that the legislators don't have time to read them all. The people surely don't have time to read them all, to learn about them, and it's all squished together. So what would be much better is just to meet 5 working days per month. During odd number years, do that every month, and even number years every month, and on odd number years, do it every other month. This would, one, allow the legislators to read the bills before they vote on them. Two, it would allow the people more time to learn about these different bills which have been written. Number three, it would give the legislators more time back in their districts to meet with their people, to be with their families. And four, it would remove the need for special sessions. For example, if we got a special session, the governor's going crazy, you don't have to wait till the first of the year to do anything about it, because the legislature be meeting every single month or every other month. Would save the people of Kentucky tens of thousands of dollars every time that there's a special session. Probably hundreds of thousands of dollars. I can solidly say hundreds of thousands of dollars from not having to have special sessions. So I think that'd be a wonderful thing for our state. And then third and filing has to do with running for office. Up to a few years ago, if you wanted to file to run for office, you had till basically the end of January. Now, I want to tell you, this is exactly what happens. During the month of January in the state legislature, they didn't do anything. Oh, they're technically in session, but no important bills at all were passed. Nothing was done. It was a waste of a month. And here's the reason why. Because the people who are up there is like, well, if I vote for a controversial bill, that might make somebody back in my home district decide that they want to run against me. So let's not handle any controversial bills during the entire month of January till the filing deadline is over. And then, hey, it's too late, sucker. You got to wait for at least 2 years before you can do anything. And they're counting on short-term memory and people forgetting what's going on. So here, 2 or 3 years ago, they passed a law and said, okay, we're going to move the filing deadline up to like the very first Friday of the year, the first Friday after the first Monday. And so that means as soon as they come in, they haven't done anything the first week. They're getting sworn in. They haven't voted on anything. And so then if they do something you don't like, it's too late. You cannot file to run against them. So that's the reason why that was moved up. And just I'm telling everybody in Kentucky, that's the reason why now everybody knows it. So that is the history of it. That's what's going on now. So what is the bill that you propose, Mr. Watts? What's the solution? This would be a great thing for the people of Kentucky. Move the filing deadline to the last day of the legislative session. A lot of people in the legislature are like, oh my word, I hope YouTube takes this video out. I sure don't want that idea getting out there. Why would they be terrified of moving the last day you can file to run for office to the last day of the legislative session? Tell you why, because that means every bill they vote on during the year, if somebody doesn't like it, they can file to run against them and they would be more answerable to the people. Well, this would be a great thing to make legislators even more answerable to the people. If there are good legislators, like I'm doing what the people sent me up here to do, they should have no problem with that because the people sent me here to do this, I did it, the people should be happy with that. But this would make them a little more answerable to we the people. So that's some of the top 10 bills that I think we should keep our eyes on. Three ideas I think would be good bills. I think the chances of them actually getting written are very low, but we should start this conversation. And if you got some good ideas for bills, put it in the comments section. And if we get some great ones, we'll start talking about those the next time we do a bill update. And let's we the people come up with some of the ideas for what we think would be some great laws here in Kentucky. Well, that's about all the time that we have for this week. So until next week, I'm Lee Watts for Patriot Point, reminding you that liberty is not a spectator sport.